Good afternoon. Today I have two important announcements to make. The first is the election date. Under the last government, the practice began sharing the election date at the beginning of election year. Early announcements allow for planning and for preparation by the Electoral Commission, by government agencies and political parties, and is, I believe, best practice. That's why in 2020, we announced at the beginning of election year, and I do so again today. The general election for 2023 will be held on Saturday, the 14th of October. I can see in the room who has won the sweepstake. In setting this date, I've considered the advice of the Electoral Commission, public holidays and school holidays, the advanced voting periods, and important events and fixtures. I believe this date best accommodates each of these factors. Consideration of the date over the summer and the impending election and new political term has also given me time for reflection. I'm entering now my sixth year in office, and for each of these years, I have given my absolute all. I believe that leading a country is the most privileged job anyone could ever have, but also one of the more challenging. You cannot and should not do it unless you have a full tank, plus a bit in reserve for those unexpected challenges. This summer, I had hoped to find a way to prepare not just for another year, but another term, because that is what this year requires. I have not been able to do that. And so today I'm announcing that I will not be seeking re-election, and that my term as Prime Minister will conclude no later than the 7th of February. This has been the most fulfilling 5.5 years of my life, but it has also had its challenges. Amongst an agenda focused on housing, child poverty, and climate change, we encountered a major biosecurity incursion, a domestic terror event, a major natural disaster, a global pandemic, and an economic crisis. The decisions that have had to be made have been continual, and they have been weighty. But I'm not leaving because it was hard. Had that been the case, I probably would have departed 2 months into the job. I am leaving because with such a privileged role comes responsibility. The responsibility to know when you are the right person to lead and also when you are not. I know what this job takes, and I know that I no longer have enough in the tank to do it justice. It's that simple. But I absolutely believe and know there are others around me who do. We've achieved a huge amount in the last 5 years, and I'm so proud of that. We are in a fundamentally different place on climate change than where we were, with ambitious targets and a plan to achieve them. We have turned around child poverty statistics and made the most significant increases in welfare and the state housing stock that we've seen in many decades. We've made it easier to access education and training. We've improved the paying conditions of workers and shifted our settings towards a high-wage, high-skilled economy. And we've worked hard to make progress on issues around our national identity. And I believe that teaching history in schools and celebrating our own Indigenous national holiday will all make a difference for years to come. And we've done that while responding to some of the biggest threats to the health and economic well-being of our nation, arguably, since World War II. The team that has done all of that, they have been some of the best people I've ever had the privilege of working with, and they are well placed to take us forward as we continue to focus on our economic recovery with one of the strongest economies in the world. They are also a team who are incredibly well placed to contest the next election. In fact, I am not leaving because I believe we can't win the election, but because I believe we can and will, and we need a fresh set of shoulders for that challenge. I know there will be much discussion in the aftermath of this decision as to what the so-called real reason was. I can tell you that what I'm sharing today is it. The only interesting angle that you will find is that after going on 6 years of some big challenges, I am human. Politicians are human. We give all that we can for as long as we can, and then it's time. And for me, it's time. I intend to remain the member for Mount Albert through till April. This will give me a bit of time in the electorate before I depart and also spare them and the country a by-election. Beyond that, I have no plan, no next steps. All I know is that whatever I do, I will try and find ways to keep working for New Zealand, and that I'm looking forward to spending time with my family once again. Arguably, they are the ones that have sacrificed the most out of all of us. And so to Neve, Mum is looking forward to being there when you start school this year. And to Clark, let's finally get married. As for the next Labour leader, the caucus has 7 days to ascertain whether one individual holds more than two-thirds of the caucus support. Caucus has agreed today that a vote will occur in 3 days' time, on Sunday, the 22nd of January. If a leader is successfully elected, I will issue my resignation soon after to the Governor-General and a new Prime Minister will be sworn in. If no one is able to garner this level of support within caucus, the leadership contest will go to the wider membership. My opportunity to thank the many people I need to will likely come in April when I depart Parliament, 15 years after having been sworn in. Till then, I see my role to help the Labour Party, who I consider to be my family, navigate this next phase, and then to leave the next colleague who takes on this role all the space they need to make their mark. For my part, I want to finish with a simple thank you to New Zealanders for giving me this opportunity to serve and to take on what has and will always be the greatest role of my life. I hope in return, I leave behind a belief that you can be kind but strong, empathetic but decisive, optimistic but focused, that you can be your own kind of leader, one that knows when it's time to go. I'm happy to take your questions.
Prime Minister, who are you backing in the leadership race?
I will not be backing any one individual candidate. At this point, I see it as my role to help navigate the party through the next steps. I can tell you, having met with the caucus this morning, I'm confident that they will do that swiftly, decisively, with good grace.
How much did you reflect on your personal popularity ratings when making this decision?
You'll hear in my comments that my reflection was entirely on the next 4 years. And determining whether to run an election, you need that commitment to see you through a three-year period. And as much as I have taken great joy in this job, I would be giving a disservice to this country and to the Labour Party if I continued knowing that I just don't have enough in the tank for another 4 years.
What specifically was the moment that you realised that you couldn't do it anymore?
Look, you'll also hear from my reflections that there hasn't been one singular moment. Not one point in time. I think the cumulative challenges that we've faced as a team, and they have been extraordinary, has taken its toll. I consider this job a privilege, but I am also human, and so my reflection has been an entirely personal one.
And
I will add that I had the support of my family to continue. In fact, some members of my family, particularly close to me, wanted me to continue, but they've supported my decision.
Prime Minister, so much of the Labour Party brand is built around Jacinda Ardern. Are you worried now that you stepping down will effectively hand the election over to the National Party?
Not at all. In fact, you'll hear in my comments today, I've taken this decision because I believe this team has the strength to lead us successfully through the next election. There is a group of extraordinary people in the room next to me. I have never led on my own. I have led with a strong, resilient, capable, intelligent team around me. They have experience and the expertise, They've already got New Zealand into the best possible position for the challenges that we face, and I believe their record and their experience will carry them through the next election.
What would you put as your top moment of your tenure as Prime Minister?
I think I've spent so much time thinking hard about this decision because it is such a critical one, that there hasn't been too much time, I think, for self-reflection. I imagine that I'll do that in the coming months ahead. But I consider every moment, even the hardest of moments, to be a privilege. It's one thing to lead your country in peace times, it's another to lead them through crisis. There's a greater weight of responsibility, a greater vulnerability amongst the people. And so in many ways, I think that will be what sticks with me. I had the privilege of being alongside New Zealand during crisis, and they place their faith in me.
Prime Minister, the job of Prime Minister has become more dangerous in the last few years. Threats to your office have increased. How much did that weigh on you in making this decision?
It didn't. It is, as I say, cumulatively, we've seen these events, and I've listed a few of them, and they have been taxing because the weight, the sheer weight and continual nature of them, there's never really been a moment where it's ever felt like we were just governing. But I don't want to leave the impression that the adversity you face in politics is the reason that people exit. Yes, it does have an impact. We are humans after all, but that was not the basis of my decision. In politics, you have adversity, you have disagreement. We need to nurture that. We also need to do our best to make sure it's respectful, but that was not the basis of my decision.
Would it be a surprise if anyone grabbed Robertson as Prime Minister?
I have received the blessing of Grant to share with you what he has shared with caucus today, and that is he will not be putting himself forward to be a potential candidate as a future leader. He has put out his own statement to be able to describe that in his own words, but that is the message that he has shared with caucus today.
Is New Zealand ready for a Māori Prime Minister?
Oh, again, as I say, I will not speculate on the future considerations of the caucus. What I can share with you is their very clear sense of responsibility that they have the task ahead of them to choose a Labour leader and therefore the next Prime Minister in a decisive way, in a way that gives consideration to the needs of New Zealand, and that is where their focus will remain. So they are entirely externally focused. This is about the public, not about ourselves.
There was apologies I haven't seen, but will Grant Robertson also be standing down?
This is simply about the Labour leadership.
Have you essentially destabilised Labour with this
move? No. I think every leader and every political leader has to reflect on the transitions that need to be made. It's about knowing when you've got what it takes and what is needed to lead, but also having the courage to know when you don't. And so for me, it's about making sure that this transition is as smooth as possible. There's no doubt this is a big change, but I also absolutely believe that we have the capability in our team to continue to carry New Zealand forward.
And when did you realise that, sort of to use your metaphor, that you were starting to run on fumes, that the tank was emptying?
Yeah, look, it's fair to say that, as we loomed closer to Christmas in the summer period, I decided to give myself a chance to really reflect on whether I had what was needed. As I say, I had hoped that I would find what I needed to carry on over that period, but unfortunately I haven't, and I would be doing a disservice to New Zealand to continue.
What was the reaction of your
regrets or unfinished business?
Oh, look, I think anyone who leaves this place thinking that the job's done didn't have enough of a to-do list. Of course, there will be things that I wish I could have continued working on, but I also have no regrets because I've lived to the best of my ability in this job by putting all those values that got me into politics first and foremost and front and centre. Will there have been things I'd have done differently? Absolutely. But I also leave knowing I did my best.
What was the reaction of caucus today when you told them?
It's fair to say they were surprised, but they also understood. One thing with a group of people who you work so closely with is they get to know you at a personal level. And so I think they could see that I'd given everything, and they didn't begrudge this decision.
Did they all find out at once, or did you have an inner circle that you were informed?
I met with Cabinet this morning. I met with caucus, obviously, as scheduled. There were only the odd individual who I'd spoken to, but in their capacity as friends.
Who were they?
I'd rather not get into some of those details, but it was a very, very small number, and some without much notice.
How would you like New Zealanders to remember you as friends?
As someone who always tried to be kind.
What time did you tell your colleagues this morning?
So after the opening of caucus, so essentially straight off the bat, Cabinet met at 7:30 a.m. this morning, caucus soon after. Some senior members I met with last night, and as I say, a very small handful who had any other prior notice. Ultimately, I didn't want to burden them with this decision. It was my own. I knew once I'd made it that my mind was not for changing.
It would be fair to say...
When you wake up on the figure of the eighth or whatever day, when you're not public, what's the first thing you're going to do?
Probably have the cup of tea that Clark will inevitably make me in bed. And I don't say that in jest, that's actually been his practice for the last 5 years, if I'm not up before him, and probably make Neve breakfast. I haven't yet.
It would be fair to say 5 minutes, would it not?
4-year-olds are chatty, couldn't run the risk. There's a reason I listed that in my remarks, because I have considered that one of my great privileges. I actually remember that it was the day I was welcomed onto a marae in Rotorua in one of my first pōhiri as Prime Minister, that in that moment the weight and responsibility of the job really came at me, and it has done every single pōhiri I've done since. I believe that we have strengthened our relationships with Māoridom, and that we have made progress. Now the key is to keep going. Yes. Do you know that I'm not unusual? Firstly, I am a politician who is first and foremost human. And so leadership means being willing to step back and recognise when actually it's time for someone else to do the job. And that I'm not alone in the fact that politicians, and the ones that I work with at least, are constantly thinking about how they can best serve. They're constantly thinking about what they can do on behalf of their communities. They're not all there for power. They're not all there to be in the front seat. They're there to be in a team that makes a difference. And so that's probably why my colleagues aren't surprised, because they can see that I'm trying to make the best decision for New Zealand. If I don't have what it takes, I need to let someone else take on this job.
And leadership has a huge impact on party and politics.
Yes. You could name every single issue of concern to New Zealanders. Labour is the one that has policies and plans which they are already implementing to support New Zealanders through. We have one of the strongest economies in the world right now, despite great, great international headwinds. We have the record. I believe strongly that this team has what it takes to take an agenda to the New Zealand public that they will support. I just need to make sure that they have the right leader to take them through that.
You said you haven't really focused on what happens next, but in your whole career there's been a lot of speculation that you might be off to the United Nations for a role there. Is that something on your radar, or is that something that you would consider if it was to offer to you?
This has been my entire focus. As you can see by the fact that you've not been aware of this, I've kept this essentially to myself in a very small group. And so that has not been my focus. My focus has been this decision, supporting the Labor team through this next stage. Beyond that, I have no plans other than spending a bit of time with my family and then seeing what's next. But that hasn't been my focus.
You might not have plans, or might not be your focus, but you have ambitions to get to that level at the UN.
That has never been my focus, and that hasn't been my ambition. I haven't been here for that purpose. I've been here to serve New Zealand. I'll then take each day as it comes.
Has Calvin Davis indicated whether he is interested in the...
As I said, I had the blessing of Grant Robertson to share his news. I haven't sought that from any other member, so I'll allow any other caucus member to speak for themselves. But what I would just reflect on is that when the National Party went through a not dissimilar transition between John Key and Bill English, they took, I believe, 7 days to make their decision. Labor has taken the decision to vote in essentially three. They do want to make sure they move quickly. They're very united in their focus. They know that they need to be focused on supporting New Zealanders in this time, and so that is why they're looking to move as quickly as they can.
Did anyone flag that they were interested in
the focus? Again, the focus here very much for the team has been making sure that the process is decisive. That's what everyone has been reflecting on, and that's why I have information to share with you on that today. Otherwise, I'll leave individuals to speak to their own positioning there.
Will you still be involved in the campaigning, in the election campaign?
As you'll have heard me say, I actually believe it's really important to allow a new leader to make their mark. I will be there for whatever needs, advice, support that can be provided or asked. Well, sure. I started out as a leaflet deliverer. I'll always be a leaflet deliverer.
Leadership contests can be quite divisive.
Yeah.
Do you anticipate that that could happen
again? No, I mean, look, it's ultimately, there will be, of course, debate, discussion. That's what you'd expect in a healthy democracy. That's what you'd expect in a healthy team. But this is also a team that, as I say, they're focused on New Zealand. They know their job is to move as quickly as they can, as decisively as they can, and as gracefully as they can.
But do you accept now have made your team's job so much harder with this decision?
No, I don't. The job for them would have been hard if they had a leader who didn't have enough in the tank to take them through.
Did you seek the counsel of somebody like Helen Clark that has been through this, or dare I say John Key, who has been through a similar situation?
No. As I say, ultimately I felt it was a decision I had to take responsibility for. That's not to say I didn't take the counsel of a small group, but as I say, small group, and ultimately my decision.
What's been the toughest part of the job?
Probably naming one as a single tough moment when there are so many options. Managing to make progress on all the things that you are there to achieve while still taking on the challenges of the day. Yeah, housing as a crisis, child poverty, climate change doesn't go away just because you have a pandemic. So just continuing to keep up that momentum, but we have. So I'm so proud of that.
Are you comfortable with the state that you're leaving New Zealand in?
Yes. It is not an easy time. There are struggles out there for many, absolutely. There is much work to be done, absolutely. But have I given all I can to put us in the best possible position? I have, and I know that hand on heart.
Clear.
No, there hasn't been a singular moment. As I say, nearing the end of the year, I thought I really need to give myself the summer to really consider whether or not I have what it takes to continue. Once I'd realised that I didn't, I knew unfortunately there wasn't much alternative other than to hand over now. I did give some thought as to whether or not there was a way to complete the term, but our system just simply doesn't work like that. I mean, that is what it is. Perhaps I'll take a final two questions, Amelia, and then... Oh, I haven't, to be honest, haven't finalised some of those plans. As you'll see, I've said that I anticipate that I will resign and the new Prime Minister will be sworn in by the 7th of February. depending on the process, it could be earlier. So that's something that I'll work through with the new leader, Mark. Look, again, similar answer. I'll work that through. Mark.
When you became Prime Minister in 2017, you probably didn't expect to deal with a lot of things you ended up dealing with.
I didn't expect to be Prime Minister either.
In hindsight, what are the tricks that it takes to measure good governance?
This is my view, and it is perhaps not a commonly held one, but the top of my list would be empathy. Unless you can... at least work to comprehend the experience of others. Very hard to deliver solutions and respond to crises without that starting point. So that's been a really important principle for me, empathy. And I think we have to be willing to reject some of those old characteristics as well. If you ask someone of my generation what they believe a politician to be and to name some of the traits, I doubt that they would list kindness. I doubt that they would list empathy, but I hope the next generation does.
I was just going to ask about, was there a best day that you had as a job, or one moment that you realized
there's been so many of those, and I don't want to lose sight of that. You know, moments where I've just felt so proud, the progress that we've made on climate, you know, standing in the parliament and speaking on zero carbon legislation, making the change to our public holidays to bring in Matariki, standing at Pōhiri on Marae and seeing that we are making progress and taking on some really big challenges head on, seeing that we're making progress on child poverty, those have all been incredibly important moments for me. I couldn't list one. And so I wouldn't want this last 5.5 years to simply be about the challenges. For me, it's also been about the progress. I think we'll call it a day.
Thank you.